Oil filters are a critical component to keep your engine running great. In this video, we're going to be looking at three different oil filters: a leading aftermarket filter, an OEM filter, and our factory racing parts oil filter. There are three things that our engineers focus on when designing an oil filter: build quality, efficiency, and finally, fitment. The first thing we're going to look at today is build quality. What you should be looking for in build quality is solid steel construction, reliable end caps, proper pleating, and a bypass valve that is properly placed on the top of the filter. You'll notice here that all three filters have a steel case, but once we start looking at the rest of the filter, that's where you're going to see a difference. And we've conveniently cut into these filters to be able to show you the differences. So let's check out the end caps of these oil filters. You'll see that this OEM filter and our factory racing parts filter both have metal end caps, whereas the big box filter comes with a cardboard pleated end cap. When it comes to overall build quality, I think anyone would be hard pressed to argue that cardboard is an adequate substitute for a metal end cap. We've deconstructed these oil filters so that we can show you the media inside of the filters. Filters should have a pleat pack, which is this here, that provides consistent and uniform filtration to prevent particulates from reaching the engine. Frankly, we were surprised by the OEM pleat pack. We actually found a tear in it, and it had yet less uniformity than we expected. With the aftermarket filter, we saw even less uniformity with these large spaces, indicative of fewer pleats, thus less available filtration area. With less filtration area, that can result in high initial pressure drops and low dirt holding capacity. Now let's look at the bypass valves on all three filters. Starting with the aftermarket filter, you'll see that the bypass valve is on the bottom of the filter. Contaminants can collect on the bottom of filters, and if you have to rely on the bypass valve to get oil to lubrication points, the dirty oil could flow out and into the engine bearings. The OEM and factory racing parts filters have taken a different approach, where the bypass valves are on the top of the filter. So if the valve opens, oil will still get to critical engine parts, but the dirt and contaminants remain on the bottom of the filter. The last thing we're going to look at is the anti-drain back valve, which is sitting on the top of each of these filters. In the aftermarket filter, this anti-drain back valve feels a little bit like cheap rubber. However, in the OEM filter and the factory racing parts filter, both of the anti-drain back valves are made of high-quality silicone materials, which helps protect your filter in extreme temperatures. Before an oil filter gets to market, they have to go through a series of tests designed to verify their efficiency. These tests can include measuring the strength of the pleats, how strong the seals are, the filter's ability to prevent contaminants to reaching lubrication points, and how much dirt a filter can hold. So take a look at this data. Independent testing shows that the factory racing parts filter has a 92.3% efficiency score in a single pass test, while the OEM filter and the aftermarket filters came in at 78% and 74.4% respectively. Now that's a big difference in how well the filter keeps dirt and particulates out of your engine. The last thing we'll look at is fitment. When you're looking for a new oil filter, you want to be sure it's going to fit properly in your vehicle. The engineers at Factory Racing Parts have done the work to ensure proper oil filter fitment on your vehicle while meeting OEM requirements, plus including the exact amount of oil and the correct viscosity to make our oil change kits the best in the industry.